I'm not doing a single fucking thing.
Is this Oh, she's a stripper.
Just a few hours that Big Brother gave to these Shine Your Eyes housemates to party in the jacuzzi. They lost their home training. Guys, I'm talking about all the chaos that happened last night. A lot of chaotic mess here and there. It became a crazy emotional ride. It became a very, very messy game of, you know, concentration that they could not even finish because they were not daring enough. I mean, guys, a lot of madness was just happening here and there, here and there, here and there. And I'm going to tell you all about it on this particular episode of Frankly Speaking with Gloria Elijah. So you need to watch till the end of this video without skipping one bit. Let's start. Turned out that some of these housemates, they were lightheaded because a lot of them last night were drunk. We're talking about the likes of Cross and Sammy. Guys, they were so drunk that whatever they were dancing in the kitchen with White Money guys, I have no freaking idea.
what's doing? Oh Lord!
Sammy literally turned himself into a stripper, dancing and grinding on the kitchen counter. And I'm like, dude, come on! Alcohol is a bastard. Hey, alcohol is a freaking bastard. And guys, what was Cross doing? Oh my God, guys, I just couldn't understand, but it was quite hilarious. I mean, look how White Money is singing. Guys, and to be very frank with you, White Money himself doesn't even understand what he is singing, but what did I know is that alcohol is truly a bastard. Now, aside that, Sammy actually went to bed on time because dude did not want to fool himself, but hell no. Cross decided not to go to bed on time. So we decided to join the rest of the housemates in playing some annoying concentration games, which I will be sharing in the course of this video. But before I do so, guys, let me just quickly remind you all that today is Saturday, and you know what that means. It is our YouTube live stream that will be happening on this channel by 3 p.m. WAT. What that means is, please, whatever part of the world you are, please ensure to use Google World Clock so that you are able to keep up with the time in West Africa. So 1500 or 3 p.m. WAT is that time. Please come all out in your full glory, because today's conversation on my channel, as usual, is going to be virtual and spot on. Very, very spot on exclusive analysis that you do not want to miss out on. Let's continue with the video. Another interesting thing that happened was we now discovered that Jackie B and Tega, they had an altercation. Okay, not really an altercation, but kind of a one-off from Jackie B to Tega at the backstage during their presentation. So guys, what actually happened was that Jackie B had gone into the backstage and was looking for a costume. So Tega had been shushing her, you know, telling her, shh, don't make noise, don't make noise. And I think it's because they were all using their mics for their presentation. And guys, we all know how it is. When you are shouting, you know, I don't know, it seems like whoever controls the sounds in Biggie's house tends to amplify the sound of the mic. So Tega was trying to control people from making too much noise, and that was what infuriated Jackie B, that she went on an outburst and was warning Tega that in your life, do not ever talk to me like that, don't ever come at me like that, blah, 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 blah. Much later, I heard Jackie B explaining to Nini that for her, she feels like she's a mom, Tega is also a mom, both of them, they have kids. Her kid is 10 years old, Tega's child is about 5 years old. So what gave Tega the right to come at her as if she's a child? Tega's explanation kind of infuriated Princess, who is already taking sides in the whole matter itself. So she was already gingering and she was hyperventilating and she was shouting,
nobody can try in the house, nobody can do anything, blah, 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 that are old. She has anger issues, that she came to Biggie's house and she's trying to handle
anger issues. I'm like, girl, calm down. Why are you angry now? It's Biggie's house for angry people. Whilst all of that was happening, Beatrice had broken down in tears in the games room upstairs. Now, I do not know how Peace found her out, but then Peace went there and was trying to console her and trying to even know the root cause of you know, her sad state. And guys, honestly, it was quite emotional. It really touched me. But at the end of the day, from what Beatrice was saying, she felt out of place in the midst of the rest of the 21 other Shine Your Eyes housemates. She had inferiority complex because one, she felt like she doesn't know how to talk. She felt like she wasn't saying the right thing. She said she didn't just know how to behave or even carry herself in the midst of the rest of the housemates, that she looks at them when they have conversations, the way they flow with one another, and she wonders, how do they do it? You know, in fact, she feels completely out of place. And that kind of made her feel like she doesn't know what she's doing or whether she's at the wrong place at the wrong time. In fact, she just felt like she wasn't deserving of being in Biggie's house. She felt like she wasn't worth the chance of being in Biggie's house. And guys, try as much as Peace tried to console her. At some point, I was really upset that Peace was there. I mean, hey, Peace had been trying to convince the rest of the housemates before that Beatrice and Earrings were the wild cards in the house. You know, so seeing her there, you know, playing the role of big sister, trying to put Beatrice in a good mood, I just felt like, Peace, who the hell are you? Like, for real, who are you? Like, this girl, are you sure you're not a chameleon? And guys, there's another theory I have about Peace, which I will be sharing during the live stream today. So please do not miss out, because I'm going to explain that theory in details. But then one thing that Beatrice kept on saying was that she wants to talk to an elderly person, a more mature person, because she has a lot of questions about herself, a lot of questions about her life, which she feels that a professional would rightly answer. And guys, I feel like she was referring to a shrink. So I know that Big Brother was hearing, and there's one thing I love about the show is that when housemates begin to feel concerned about their mental health, the organizers of the show make provisions for a shrink, I think in the diary room, you know, for the housemates to have a one-on-one session with the shrink. And I think it's also in the provisions of their rule books too. So I feel like Beatrice is going through an emotional meltdown. Another thing I also feel could be the problem is that, you know, from the story she shared about herself, Beatrice got married at the age of, I think, 17, and then she had a child. So I feel like she did not grow up. Yes, she spent her formative years being a wife and a mother. And guys, when things like that happen to human beings, what that means is they do not get to enjoy the prime of their years, of their life. And so when they are now growing up in age, when they are now advancing, they begin to feel like they are left out. You know, they begin to feel a certain kind of way. Guys, let me not just go into it in details, but I just feel like Beatrice definitely needs to talk to a shrink, all right? Otherwise, her self-confidence is going to be zero throughout the show, and it's going to terribly affect her gains. What do you think, guys? Let me know in the comment section below. On a lighter note, another very serious and interesting thing that was about to happen last night was between Boma and Arin. Guys, I was watching these two people very, very closely. I'm like, hey, what the hell is going on? I mean, what in the name of Big Brother? What in the name of Shine Your Eyes? What is going on under the sheet, under the duvet? Because, guys, these people, I'm talking about Boma, Arin, Saga, Maria, Pere, Nini, who else? Cross, yes. And at some point, Peace, they were all playing a game of concentration. So the crazy rules of the game was that for every turn that you miss, you have to strip off one item off your body. Yes. So Pere had stripped and stripped, and the only thing left on his body was his boxers. So he ran away. He said he wanted to go and urinate, but we all knew that he wasn't daring enough, you know, to remove his boxers. Now, remember also, guys, I think I mentioned in my previous video that the guys, they were all conniving on how to get to cuddle with the ladies in the house, because according to them, the ladies have been playing hard to get. They've been playing as if they are tough, you know, and Biggie had been busy, very, very busy, doing the Lord's work, increasing the AC to over 100% degrees. So everybody in the house was freezing. They were all cold. You know, so the guys were saying that night, yes, that they were going to try as much as possible to cuddle with those ladies by force. And guys, remember, the only people in the house that had been successfully cuddling in that house are Sammy and Angel, okay? So every other guy, they've not been able to catch any of the ladies in their bed for cuddles. And so guys, last night, Arin, all in the name of, oh my god, I'm tipsy, I feel very, very drunk, all in the name of, oh, we are playing the game of concentration, we are playing the game of sharing, blah, 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 she jumped into her bed. I don't know if it's her bed or Boma's bed, but both of them were sharing on the same bed. And guys, guess what was happening? They were talking about Pere refusing to remove his boxers. Arin seriously wanted to see what Pere had between his legs, but Pere wasn't in for it. Another interesting thing was that Ari started questioning Boma about what was between his legs, to the point of even asking Boma, oh, does it grow bigger when you pee? I'm like,
you, come on girl, you cannot tell me that you did not study biology in school. When did you learn that when a man pee-pees, his pee-pee-wee-wee grows bigger like that?
Wow, come on, is it the alcohol speaking or Ari? What? And then guys, before I knew it, Boma's hands were leaving where it was, and they were coming towards our inside under the bed, under the sheet. And I was watching like, hey, people are not fingering or doing anything, no? Because if you are, I will find out. But guys, at the end of the night, yeah, jokes aside, they were able to find warmth with each other. They cuddled. I don't think they did anything. No, they didn't do anything further. They cuddled. However, Saga was seriously making advances at Nini, but Nini was not just giving him the green light. Maria had slept off. Nini at some point, I think she left that place because they were all snuggled too close for comfort, and I was very, very suspicious. Saga was just all over Nini. He wanted to cuddle, he wanted to touch, he wanted to do stuff, but Nini wasn't really having it. But then she was kind of playing along, and then the guys were now conversing about it. So Angel was now advising the guys on how to approach the ladies, on how to toast the ladies. That is not for people to just sit down, bring your A game to the house, approach these ladies, you know, talk to them, blah, blah, blah. And then they were asking Angel who she liked in the house. She said she likes Sammy, but it seems like Sammy is not ready to play ball. Guys, you know what that means. Angel, for the past couple of days now, has been trying to get Sammy to get down with her in the bed. I mean, Sammy's bed. But Sammy is not having any of it. And so she now said that she actually has backups in the house. That some of her backups include Pere, there's Cross. There's also, what's this person's name? Oh, guys, I can't really remember. But she said that she has a couple of backups in the house. So if Sammy does not agree, then she's going to move on to other guys. Hey, wow. Come on, all this tea is very hot. I don't even know how I'm even managing to dish it out to you guys. Listen, another interesting thing that was happening in one corner of the house again was Emmanuel and Liquor Rose. Now, guys, during the jacuzzi party, Liquor Rose and Emmanuel, they are started talking, you know, intensely, in-depthly. And guys, remember, Emmanuel had been liking Liquor Rose one way or the other, but he had not approached her to talk because that dude actually has pride. His ego did not allow him to go and talk to her. But then when he saw all the dance moves that she was bursting at the poolside, he went to talk to her. Before we knew it, oh my God, she was grinding this guy. And the guy was like, like in his mind, tomorrow's at dinner party. My friend, like this dude was just literally planning in his mind how he was going to do it. Liquor Rose, probably during the Saturday night party of tonight. But guys, listen, let's just watch out and see how it all plays out. Meanwhile, guys, I am really, really curious to see what's going to happen today between Boma and Aaron. Is this the beginning of a new kind of attraction between both of them or not? Let us watch out and see. And this is where I'm going to end this particular episode of Frankly Speaking with Glory Elijah. Thank you all so much for watching. Please let me know your thoughts about all the details that I have spilled on this particular episode, and I'll do well to respond to all of you. And please do not forget to join me today by 3 p.m. WAT on my virtual live stream on my channel. All right? I'll see you guys shortly. Have an amazing day. Bye.